seldom do we see two productions of one play by different groups on successive days. The first weekend of April was one of those rare occasions. The show we saw twice was Photograph 51, Anna Ziegler's play about Rosalind Franklin, a pioneering British scientist in X-ray crystallography. One of her X-ray diffraction images, Photograph 51, was the key piece of evidence in the discovery of the DNA molecule's double helical form. But Franklin wasn't the one who arrived at that conclusion. Before she could interpret her photographs, other researchers got a hold of them without her knowledge. They were James Watson, Francis Crick, and Maurice Wilkins. They won the Nobel Prize for their work on DNA. Franklin did not. For a long time, Franklin was best known by Watson's caricature of her in his memoir, The Double Helix. Ziegler's Photograph 51 is a fascinating study of Franklin's achievements and the difficulties she faced in her career, some of her colleagues making, some of her own. For more about that aspect of the play, I refer you to our previous episode on which Bob reviewed the staging of Photograph 51 by the West End Players Guild. I'm very glad I saw that production and the one I'm reviewing now at the Webster University Conservatory. The two directors tackled the play in different but equally enlightening ways. The reason for the interpretive divergence is an aspect of the play that we haven't talked about yet. Photograph 51 is a metadrama, that is, a play that calls attention to its own theatricality. At the very start, Franklin speaks directly to the audience and establishes that what we are seeing is a reenactment. Later, other characters comment on what has just happened on stage. At one point, Wilkins says to another character, Don Casper, "Is it absolutely necessary for you to be here?" That line puzzled me when I first heard it. Later, I learned that Casper did not start working with Franklin until after the first articles were published on the structure of DNA. Ziegler is implying in the script what she says explicitly in the author's note, that she altered timelines, facts, and events, and recreated characters for dramatic purposes. If you compare the West End and Webster sets, you can see that West End's was more realistic, and Webster's, by Kendrick Lawson Knight, was more symbolic. West End's set emphasized the drama in this metadrama, Webster's emphasized the meta, as did the style in the performances. Instead of plunging into the action, the Webster staging began with choreography suggesting the movement of molecules. The characters acted in a way that seemed appropriate for the symbolic setting, and they were physically outside the action when they discussed their differing views on what happened in their collective past. The Webster production was a capstone project for Trace Turner, a senior in the Conservatory's directing program. He was also one of the choreographers, along with Marissa Bacard. Turner had a very distinct concept of Photograph 51 as a metadrama, and he made it compelling in performance by coordinating excellent work from everyone involved. In the cast were Caleb Braxton as Franklin, Spencer Cruz as Wilkins, Nathan Fryer as an appropriately wild Watson, Andrew Lewis as Crick, Harrison Farmer as Casper, and Eleanor Robinson as Ray Gosling. The technical contributions included Nate J. Walchick's lighting, Kat Anderson's costumes, Ilea Burton's wigs and makeup, Savannah Jade Gibson's sound, Noah Valenti's music, Bradley Fertitta's dialect coaching, and Josie Wells' dramaturgy. It is a sign of the strength of Photograph 51 that disparate interpretations were complementary rather than clashing.
And it was lucky for us that we were able to see both of them and practically on top of one another, a play that I hadn't seen before.
And I'm very glad to have seen them both because I think they enriched each other.
Yes.